The challenge, then, is to try to accommodate the various demands for growth around the estuary, whilst maintaining the variety and quality of its important habitats and species, and its sense of wilderness. Any response needs to be based on a knowledge of the pressures and an understanding of the complexities of environmental change.
We've got a number of different conflicts here, or things to balance is the way I look at them, really. We've got to look not only at the environment, as we've talked about, but also the economy is hugely important. People do live and work here, and it's important that they should continue to be able to do that, and that we should continue to look for ways to encourage that growth. The priorities, I think, are in a way to inform and educate a lot of people, so that perhaps some perceptions that people have might be dispelled, or they might become more aware and therefore change their behaviour and become more responsible in the way that they actually treat the area. We can't just build on every available area of coast. It's not a sustainable approach. With rising sea levels and so forth, if you build there, they're going to get eroded, knocked into the sea within years. You've got to take a longer term approach, not just what can we do this year, but or 5 years, but much over much longer scale, to actually start working now to get the research in place, but also to actually encourage people to come with you in that. As far as we're concerned, we're looking at the potential and growth, but trying to do it where you're not going to actually damage the environment.
The three themes we've been exploring, change, contest and response, indicate that it's neither possible nor desirable to treat nature as somehow apart, separate from human society. The estuary shows how nature and society are inseparable, interconnected, indissoluble. Humans can affect environmental change for better or for worse. We've seen how rising seas make the existing environment unsustainable in the long term. Achieving sustainable forms of development is the challenge for the future.
Yeah, this is a very fragile environment. We have to work very closely with nature. We have to understand nature to be successful. It is a sustainable industry in this period of difficult change, when a lot of the fisheries are going down and not sustainable. Because of the way we work the creek, we're farming these oysters and taking a lot of care with the creek, then we can make it sustainable. And we work very, very closely with nature to do this.
To look at a sustainable way forward, so that you're identifying all the issues of concern around here, embracing both obviously the environmental aspects, but not limited to that, but looking at the economy, looking at social aspects, and actually trying to link those all in together, really, and find a sustainable way forward where you're obviously encouraging the growth of the area, but as long as it's in a sustainable way.
In most people's eyes, sustainability means things will not change. And we have to bear in mind that coastlines are pleasurable, and estuaries in particular, because they are constantly changing. And we have to get used to the idea that constant change, in actual fact, is the order of the day. And that if a bit of coastline washes away, it doesn't actually matter. And if perhaps bird populations shift or plant populations shift, then that doesn't matter either. What we have to think about is, over the course of time, that areas like this will have to gradually move inland. So sustainability must mean very much a mindset of people, an education of the people, that it doesn't mean being static.
The Blackwater estuary, like any environment, possesses features of habitat, of human influence, that make it unique. But at the same time, the example of the estuary enables us to explore those processes of change, of contest, and of response that are common to all environments. By focusing on the ever-changing relationship of land and sea, We've seen why environmental issues are so pressing, why the idea of a sustainable environment links together the natural and human worlds. Our study of this stretch of coast yields ideas and concepts that we can use to seek answers to the question, how can we make sense of our environment? Thank you.